Hey everyone, I'm Rat Skates. I'm a former major label recording artist. I'm a victim of unpaid royalties and a recovering alcoholic. Listen, young artists are in trouble. Let me show you. The word success. What does success mean to you guys? Well, you mentioned successful bands. What is it that they have that makes them successful?
A whole bunch of fans. A whole bunch of plays on MySpace, a whole bunch of fans.
Living on the road.
Living on the road.
Yeah. Living on the road seems like a good thing.
Yeah. CDs and, you know, FYE, Hot Topic, you know.
We want to become, you know, we want to become one of the biggest bands in the world. You know, that's been our goal since the beginning. You know, we don't, you know, want to just settle for the underground. You know, we want to take over the entire world.
Yeah. Play at big venues, get our name out there, hopefully get signed. That's our dream.
Okay. It sounds typical, right? The stage, the fans, the glory, wanting to be somebody. Now, all these bands told me they were doing really well on the DIY route, selling their own CDs, etc. Notice they didn't say anything about money. Is that good or bad? How old are you?
I'm 22.
How old are you?
21.
Okay. Are you guys trying to get signed to a record label?
Yes. Yeah, yeah.
Are you guys trying to get signed to a record deal?
Yes.
That's one of our goals, actually, to get signed by a record label, actually.
Hopefully get signed one day would actually really be sick. It's like our main goal.
You see, there's still a seed planted up there that says signing a recording contract is this must-do thing. Where did they get this idea? Where do you get your guidance? Where do you get your where do you get help from?
We pretty much see how other bands do it, and we're trying to follow as much in their footsteps.
Where are you getting most of your advice from at this point?
Our advice doesn't come from anywhere besides friends that we have in bigger bands.
Tell me why getting signed is one of your goals.
Well, that's how, you know, that's pretty much what bands do, you know? Like, all the bands we listen to, they're all signed.
But how are you figuring out what step to take next?
By making a lot of mistakes.
Yes.
They just said, follow our footsteps and make mistakes. Okay, mistakes are a requirement when you're in your 20s, but do they know exactly what our mistakes were? What do they know about making money from playing music?
To really see a profit though, I mean, you either have to get signed to a big label immediately.
When it comes down to it, it's being signed to a label, you really have to try and look at it as a partnership.
Yeah.
You have to work, you know, your band has to work just as hard as the label's working, and hopefully the label's working really hard.
Well, that hopefully thing that you're saying, how do you gauge that hopefully?
Just always on personal relationships.
Yep.
Okay, multiple issues there. A partnership based on personal relationships? Why have we always accepted the passive role in this business? These bands had to pay $200 each to play that night in a VFW room with no lights and no stage. They don't realize or care that they're being victimized. Is this a good start? What's to stop them from being completely broke and suicidal? Regardless of the generation, the perception of success and the path to get there remains exactly the same. Fear dominates and logic does not exist. They're imitating our path of mistakes exactly. That is your life as a major label recording artist. Never recouping at a 68% interest rate is a given. It's not just part of a few stories. How could we sell so many records, play sold-out shows, and be completely broke? So, what did we do when our dream turned out to be this enormous problem with no answer? We self-medicate, and the suicide process begins. Unfortunately, we had to sign. We had no choice. We didn't have the internet. We couldn't record a demo in our bedrooms, not even burn CDs. But kids today do have the choice to do all of this, to stay independent and actually turn a profit. It's a solution that works. look, we made contract mistakes that we have to live with for the rest of our lives. Now, accountability was hiding behind those we trusted to protect our best interests. We didn't understand the translation our attorney was trying to give us. We couldn't comprehend making decisions for the long term. We just lived in the moment, with the philosophy being, we'll figure it out when we get there. So what can happen when you're trying to survive in a life that you can't understand? Suicide. That's what they all had in common. It seems inconceivable. All that talent, the admiration, selling millions of records. Isn't that every kid's dream? This just happened May 24th. There were hypodermic needles and pills found by his body. 14 million records. Grammys. His wife is pregnant with their first child. He was 38. Don't kids look at him as having everything in the world? Remember this message in the movie Scarface? Their story is the same. It's the result of the dream becoming reality. We've come to accept an artist's suicide as commonplace because of how much it happens. This really disturbs me. I'm a parent. My kids are musicians. Now, the musicians I just showed you were kids once too. They were just having fun. So were their parents supposed to save them? But what if they never walked that path? Here's a fact. More than half of U.S. households harbor at least one musician. What's to stop your kid from being in that coffin? If another musician, now not a rehab counselor or his bandmates, but one who survived the dream, one who made it down his path, had sat him down and explained the reality of the dream, would he still be alive? I say yes, he would. This film is about delivering this message. The people I just showed you died from trying to live in a life they did not understand. Drugs happened to be what took them out. They couldn't fight the battle because they didn't even know who their enemies were. The magnitude of danger in this industry is not taken seriously. You are agreeing to play a lottery they designed so you can never win, but you keep buying the tickets. Kids do not understand the game, the rules, and how to win or how to lose, and the line waiting to play is endless. Let me break something open here to think about, the musician's mission statement. Sex, drugs, and rock and roll. This creed does not include the word money, so the industry says they don't care about it, so we'll take it. And they have. We let them. We gave it to them. The only thing that's changed is now it's being done consciously. Artists and fans are powerless over our addiction to sharing the experience. As the listener, you gotta turn on someone else. And as the artist, we say, all we wanna do is play, which infers we don't value our work. We're victims of our own generosity. How about the stage addiction? The stage is to the musician what the bar is to the alcoholic. They'll jeopardize their entire lives for their turn to be seen through the trend window. Now, the revelation of being disposable can kill you once you've been up on that pedestal. An enormous problem is that all kids see and hear are the glory moments, the stage, the fans, the admiration. And the illusion is that these moments are 24/7. Especially when the media bombards us with self-absorbed mannequins like the Narcissisters, who have no underlying talents to support their fame. The media insists they live the ultimate life. Now, how is this possible with no definable occupation or purpose? They haven't earned a reason to be standing on the red carpet, so they should be vacuuming it. You know, dysfunction like this is a perfect example of where lies the dream. You dream about what you're shown. You eat what you're fed because your menu is controlled. Kids know nothing at all of the reality because the labels long ago disabled us from sharing the reality. The RIAA actually says in the first line of their mission statement, they fight to enable the First Amendment rights of the artists. Now that's conditional, of course, as long as we don't talk about our royalties. Now actually, all artists do speak these truths, but they never make it to the listener. This is a business of problems. We need to talk about these things. Aren't people supposed to talk about their problems? No one to listen. That's the single biggest contributor of depression and of suicide. You know, being shut off like that is terrifying. Going from a fearless 20-year-old to a 30-year-old controlled by fear. You don't understand the contract. You're afraid to ask questions. You're afraid to make the commitment. You're afraid to pass it up. So you pick up and use, thinking you'll figure it out tomorrow. If tomorrow comes, the young artist must be able to define success for themselves. They must be completely broken from their perception of this magic wand of success from signing in this industry. Now, it's not our jurisdiction to seek revenge, but instead, unconditional abstinence from it. They must control their own futures as it should be. Independent, not dependent. Our old ideas have failed, and our dysfunction has been feeding the monster. It's afflicted the artist, the fans, and the art itself. We enabled it. It was unintentional, but still, we owe it to the kids to save them from it. If we say no, the kids will say no. They told us they will follow our footsteps. The monster will be starved to death. The empire will be disabled. Now, timing is critical because as the record label balloon deflates, other monopolies have been inflating and controlling things most of us don't even realize. And the bigger they get, the smaller we get. How about this merger? The tickets, venues, and merchandise, they completely control it. Aren't we the ones on the stage that people are paying to see? How are musicians going to feed their families? You think ticket prices are high now? Attention fans, attention artists. Meet the con artists. They swear to do their job to increase profits and satisfy shareholders. As they thrive, we stay broken, suicidal. Okay. Big problems require bold solutions. This is where you'll find them. In this film, the survivors of the dream share the secrets of success. The trauma of failure proves what works and what does not. This is their giving back for the gift of survival. It's not about shattering dreams, it's about waking up. So they understand what they're doing, how they can do it, and then it can be done. We've waited too long for this. We've lost too many lives. It's an unprecedented time in history for a permanent change. We have one chance, it's now. All right, hopefully I've helped you to understand how important this project is. Now I am looking for partners who want to march down this path with me so the kids can get down theirs. So please go to the website, welcometothedream.com, just put hyphens in between all the words and contribute whatever you can. You'll see that there's something you will receive from all levels of giving and how your contribution can be tax deductible. Look, only with our help do they have a chance. But if we do nothing, they will not survive.